Stop being negative about your beauty. Don't be insane and start being like, I'm the prettiest princess in the world. But don't be mean or hard on yourself either. Like, neither one is good. Always seek that balance. Always seek that middle ground on things. Called Mrs. Midwest. I am a blogger living in the Midwest in Michigan with my husband and dog. And this week I'm actually at my in-laws, so not my typical living room environment, but I thought this would be the perfect week to film a bunch of content for you guys. So I have covered the topic of beauty on my blog before. It's been part of my series on femininity. So if you're interested in the femininity series or anything about beauty, you can check out my blog, it's linked below. But today I'll give you my thoughts and opinions. And if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, click the notification bell, and like the video. Click the thumbs up, it really helps my channel, and leave a comment if you have any further ideas on this topic or encouragement to me, because those sweet comments really do motivate me to continue working on this content for you guys. So today's topic is why we as women should nurture and lean into our beauty, why it matters, and what can be gained from doing it. So there's been this rise in a discussion about the idea of unattainable beauty standards in our culture. And I think that the reason this idea has taken hold is because it's not completely wrong. 300 years ago, when we were on the farm or in the small town, we didn't have the internet. Like, there was no Hollywood culture. There were no Instagram models. You know, the most beautiful woman that you knew might have been your second cousin. You know, there was much fewer faces that you were exposed to, and by extension, there was a lot less beauty that you were also exposed to. You were just mostly around average people for the majority of the time, and so when you would compare yourself, it was to your second cousin or to a girl from church, and it wasn't to this Brazilian Victoria's Secret model that someone hand-plucked off the beaches of the Pacific Coast. You know, it wasn't to a gorgeous celebrity who also has a secret nose job. You know, those are the types of women that we see on a day-to-day basis. And because of that, I understand why it's so difficult for girls to feel beautiful in our modern culture. And so I don't think that the idea of unattainable beauty is completely wrong, because I do think that we are exposed to higher levels of beauty on average, and that can distort our thinking of our own looks. It is pressure filled, and I've seen people respond to this in two different negative ways. The first one can be associated with a lot of radical feminists, where they shirk off beauty standards so much that they actually destroy their beauty. Their way of rebelling against beauty standards is by not conforming at all. So, you know, that's when you get like the rainbow armpit hair, or the girls who wouldn't even take care of like basic hygiene, or maybe they would completely like destroy their hair or their face or their bodies by not caring for and nurturing their bodies. And that's one way that people have responded to this oversaturated aesthetic culture. It's by destroying beauty and destroying their personal beauty. I've also seen on this side complete obsession with beauty. And so these people's response to our oversaturated beauty culture is to dive right in and then become the most beautiful through insane plastic surgery, million-dollar wardrobes, you know, the Kylie Jenner obsession with beauty and all her sisters, you know, and that's creating this culture where we think, oh my goodness, like, I need to spend all this money to look this certain way. I need the brows, I need the lips, the clothing, I need the hair, I need it all, or I'm not beautiful. You know, that's like another way people respond. They say, you know, I need to look like that. And I think that that's also problematic, because instead of approaching beauty standards and the pressure of beauty with a balanced and healthy way that still treasures your own individuality, these people are becoming clones of themselves. And then over here, it's just like total destruction of beauty with some radical feminists, where it's like, we just don't care about your beauty standards, so I'm gonna make myself hideous and you still have to love me because a woman's beauty isn't all that matters. And they're not completely wrong. Like, a woman's beauty shouldn't be all that matters. But there's a way to approach beauty that puts all of this stuff, goodbye. Goodbye, obsession. Goodbye, destruction. Let's find balance. And the way we do that is by celebrating our individual beauty and then caring for that beauty. So in response to obsession with a specific type of beauty, we can celebrate our individual beauty. And in response to destroying beauty altogether, we can care for our beauty. So we can respond to both of these things by celebrating individual beauty and caring for our beauty. This balanced approach to beauty is all about nurturing yourself. Destroying beauty isn't a feminine approach. Obsessing over beauty isn't a feminine approach. Femininity is all about nurturing the things in your life. It's about nurturing your home, your children, your spouse, the things you do in your daily job even. And it's also about nurturing yourself. And as a woman, we are born with a measure of beauty. You know, we have those feminine features that are beautiful, and we can nurture those and step into that beauty in a way that will actually empower us and give us confidence. And the way to do that is not by obsessing over your flaws, but by taking care of your body and feeding yourself foods that will enliven your body and give off that health vitality, and also by exercising, you know, in a way that makes you happy and keeps you young and healthy. It's about caring for your hair and your skin and making sure you have clothes that make you feel beautiful, but not going crazy and spending tons and tons of money. You know, it's about nurturing in a balanced way. And it's so exciting to do this, because I did this journey in 2018 and it just completely improved my life. Taking care of my hair, my skin, stepping into my health routine, it all improved my life, and I'm happier for it. Yeah, it took work, but what good thing in life doesn't take work? Work is not something to be feared. It's not something to avoid. And I'm naturally a very lazy person. I naturally would just like to chill, you know? I just like to chill. But I had to work to improve my beauty, and it made me a better person. It made me more disciplined. And I really encourage you to not think, oh, the fact that I have to shave means I'm oppressed. It's like, no, it's just general maintenance of your body. Bodies are gross. They need maintenance. They're not great all on their own. They need cleaning. They need shaving. They need beautification. And it will help you feel so good, and it's so worth it. And that's always what I'm all about on this channel. How can we use femininity and the nurturing of it to build us into better people, happier people, stable people that can be in stable relationships and create stable communities? And that's what I'm all about, and beauty is part of that. We should not shirk off our beauty and think that that's a good thing because we can spend more time on other people. Because other people like it when you take care of yourself. When you take care of yourself, you signal to everyone around you, I'm healthy. I take responsibility for myself. I treasure myself. And because of that, I can treasure you. I can take responsibility for our relationship. I can nurture you as well, because I nurture myself. And I think that's so important. And never underestimate how much simple nurturing of yourself will actually bless people around you, especially your spouse. We all know that. Your husband will really appreciate you nurturing your outer beauty. But even children appreciate it, you know? I loved growing up and seeing my mom take time for a clay face mask on a Friday night, or go for a walk with her friend to stay in shape. It made me happy to see her tending for herself, because it made me feel like she can tend to and care for me. I'm not saying that you're a bad person if you don't do these things. I'm just encouraging you to maybe be open to diving into nurturing your own beauty and seeing it as something for you. It's not for the patriarchy. It's not for men. It's not even for other people. It's about you being your best self and improving yourself and then going on to do great things because you feel good and you look good and people sense that confidence in you. There's nothing wrong with that. I think there is a healthy way to actually challenge beauty standards without completely destroying beauty. I think that's by living into your own unconventional traits about yourself that might not be considered beautiful at the time culturally. So when skinny legs were super in and I had thick legs, it was my burden to bear. No, I didn't hide them. I was like, whatever, here's me. This is my body, and I lived into it. And I think that's kind of what you see in the Kim Kardashian. You know, she could never have skinny legs. That's just not how her body is. So instead of trying to be like the beauty standards, she just made what she was the new beautiful thing. And I think, you know, individually we can't have like that big of an impact, but I think we can have an impact in a minor way by not changing things about ourselves that we hate, but instead living into it. And as long as you're healthy, I think it's safe to live into those things. Can we see my nose? You can see my profile, perhaps. I don't have a ski slope nose. I'm okay with that because my mom didn't have a ski slope nose either. And I thought she was the most beautiful woman on the face of the planet, like for my whole life, basically. And I think that her embracing that about herself and not complaining about it really taught me like uniquely shaped noses are wonderful. And I think that's how we can also plug in with our daughters. Don't hate on yourself, especially around younger girls or around your daughter or around even your friends. Because when we all know the feeling of when a skinnier friend is like, I feel fat. And you look at her and you're like, well, I'm 4 sizes bigger than you. So if you feel fat, that makes me enormous. I think when we lean into our beauty and we nurture our beauty, we naturally are going to stop making those comments. Stop being negative about your beauty. Don't be insane and start being like, I'm the prettiest princess in the world. But don't be mean or hard on yourself either. Like, neither one is good. Always seek that balance. Always seek that middle ground on things. Don't destroy beauty. Don't be obsessed with it. And you will find wonderful, wonderful life. We are gonna wrap it up. So if you liked this video, please click the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell and please follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And of course, go to the mothership of everything, my written blog. Anyways, I had so much fun recording this. I'm gonna have a heck of a time editing it because I've been talking for so long. But again, thank you so much for watching and have a blessed and feminine day.